What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another YouTube video. Today, we're going to be playing the pitch type guessing game. I've seen a lot of people do this across the spectrum of social media. If you aren't familiar with this game specifically, this is a game to guess the type of pitch a pitcher threw. Shuffles through random videos of every pitch thrown last season. This is not true because I have seen pitches from multiple seasons. Regardless, it just shows one pitch. Gives you a variety of options to choose from, multiple choice, and you have to choose which pitch you think that pitch was. Baseball Savant. It's on their website. They've offered some new games this year. If you aren't familiar with Baseball Savant, the website, it's awesome. It's every single piece of information you would ever need to know about the sport of baseball in terms of analytics, in terms of numbers, player performance, all kinds of stuff. And most recently, this past offseason, they added some pitch type guessing games. They added some player guessing games. They added all kinds of stuff. Interactive play along type games. And we're going to do that same thing right here. So pitch type guessing game, Baseball Savant. There are 20 pitches per game. Once you go through 20 different pitches, it tells you what your final score is, your percentage correct, yada, yada, yada. So we're going to do 20 pitches in the pitch type guessing game, see how many we can get correctly. And we're going to jump straight into it. So pitch type guessing game, away we go. So a few different things about this pitch type guessing game that you can't control, right? Can't control the camera angle from behind the pitcher, which is vitally important. You can't control, the hitter. You can't control if you know the pitcher or not. It does help to know the pitcher because you know his arsenal. In this case, I believe this pitcher's name is Austin Voth, but I could be wrong on that. Regardless, it looks like 92. The glove motion of Yan Gomes from behind the plate is a little bit deceiving because it looks like he could potentially be aiming it out here as it cuts across the plate. Release point is right about here. And it cuts. It looks like it's a cutter. However, it's 92. I don't think Austin Voth throws a 92 mile an hour cutter. I think he just slightly pulls this four-seam fastball. To me, this looks like a four-seam fastball, and we are correct. One for one. Absolutely love it. Up next, this is Adbert Alzolay. This is a 94 mile an hour pitch right down the middle. If you can see, it's got a little bit of arm side movement there. Starts on the inside corner, runs back over the middle of the plate. It's a 3-0 pitch. It's a get me over. It's a sinker from Adbert Alzolay. That is two for two. Up next, this is forget his first name, Pena. Gosh, this thing's got a lot of arm side run. Very similar type of action to that last pitch we saw. This thing starts off the plate, runs its way back. We're going to guess sinker and go three for three. Love that. This is Woodford. This is, oh man, this is tough. Four seam fastball or sinker again. This is a really good pitch right on the outside corner. Jake Woodford, is that his name? Can't remember. Regardless, I think this is going to be a four seam. Four for four. Up next, Ryan Brazier. Ryan Brazier. We know his arsenal. We know he's a four seam curveball guy, but 86 for a curveball is pretty sharp. Regardless, I'm going to go curveball and it's a slider. All right. 4 out of 5. Zach Greinke, 89 miles an hour. Also, yeah, they say these are all pitches from last season. Really? Then why are there cardboard cutouts behind home plate in Houston? Thanks. This thing has a little bit of cutting action to it. I'm going to go cutter. And it's an 89 mile an hour four seam fastball from Zach Greinke. Woof. Garrett Cole, this is a four seam. We're just going to speed through that because we know Garrett Cole throws four seams. Nathan Eovaldi. Okay, so this is awesome, right? This is one where you know Eovaldi's repertoire. If you don't, then you're going to have to make a guess here. Educated guess. 70 miles an hour with some up to it. Little 12 to 6 action. You could probably guess curveball, but knowing Nathan Eovaldi's repertoire, he's a four-seam guy, cutter guy, split-finger guy, and a curveball. This is a textbook Nathan Eovaldi curveball, and it's correct. 6 out of 8, 75%. This is Jimmy Cordero, so he throws pretty darn hard. This has got some nice sinking action to it. If you notice, this thing starts right over the middle of the plate and runs its way back into the inside corner. It's a pretty nasty pitch, and it's also a sinker from Jimmy Cordero. So we are 7 out of 9 liking this so far. Matt Whistler, whistling one in on the corner. We know Matt Whistler. We know his repertoire. He throws low 90s. So this is going to be a four-seam fastball from Matt Whistler. 8 out of 10. Corbin Burns. So this one's hard. Off-centered. You know, not directly lined up behind the pitcher. This is a little bit off to the right, kind of like over the shortstop's head almost, right? We know Corbin Burns throws sinkers, and we know he throws cutters. You can kind of see the grip on this pitch. If you pick it up out of his hand, it's hard to really tell. And I also think this was supposed to be a cutter that started middle and cut down and in. I think he left this one a little bit arm side. I don't think this was a designed sinker. I believe this to be a cutter. And we know Corbin Burns' repertoire, and it's a cutter. This one, that one was sketchy. I'll be honest, that one was sketchy. We got it. All right. So Blake Taylor, I believe this gentleman's name is, left-handed bullpen pitcher for the Astros at certain points. This is also deceiving because it kind of looks like it's got some cutting action. It looks like it starts where Maldonado was set up and cuts a little bit. However, I don't think he throws a cutter. And if he did, I doubt it'd come in at 94 because that is firm for a cutter. I think we're just going to go straight four-seam fastball. Correct. 10 out of 12. Love this so far. We got 8 more left. This is Bo Burrows. This is a 91 mile an hour pitch, outside corner. This is either sinker or four seam again. I think we're just going to have to go straight four seam, see where we end up with this one. I don't think he throws hard enough for this to be like a sinker. I think this was just a four seam on the outside corner, and it's correct. 11 out of 13. Lovely. Okay, so this is Carlos Martinez. Sling it in, 93, right down the middle. The thing with Carlos Martinez is he has a sinker. He also has a four seam. 93 doesn't have a lot of sink to it. I think we're going to have to stay true here again with a four seam. Lovely. 12 out of 14. This is Ross Stripling. If you know Ross Stripling, obviously, you know, his repertoire, he's kind of over the top 12-6 type guy. Four seam fastball, throws a little bit of a cutter. This is 78 miles an hour. It's got some bend to it. Relatively easy one here. Curveball from Ross Stripling. This is Casey Mize. First overall pick. Could be wrong there. Got a bit of an odd delivery, right? Little sidearm, three-quarter slot. This is 2020. With that delivery, with that release point, he has this sinker. This ball definitely has some arm side run. The issue is, could just be his release point and the movement that comes out of a four-seam fastball from where he releases it. I think this is a sinker from Casey Mize. Correct. 14 out of 16. Loving this percentage so far. Having a really good time with this. Tony Gonsolin, again, you should know, if you know his repertoire, this helps a lot. Okay. Gonsolin is a four-seam guy. I think he's got a cutter. I think he's got a slider of some sorts. This thing coming across at 85 with a little bit of downward movement to it tells me, based on what I know of Tony Gonsolin and the movement and the type of pitch, it's either a changeup or a split-fingered fastball, right? Sinker has that type of movement as well, but it's going to come in high 80s, a lot of times low 90s. This is Tony Gonsolin. This is a split-fingered fastball, 15 out of 17. All right. This is one where we're screwed. We're screwed. We don't know the pitch. Just going to have to take a look from behind. Got to use context clues here. So Sean Reed Foley pitching to DJ LeMahieu. It looks like it's pretty straight. I think based on the context clues, watching this pitch come in, you can eliminate slider. You can eliminate curveball. I think you can eliminate changeup. Just watching the delivery, and this thing comes in pretty firm, stays high at the top of the zone. you know, you're not going to want to change up at that point in the zone. Additionally, if you notice here down on the bottom right, the score bug is cut off, but you see two balls. Now, two balls, no strikes. This could be a four-seam fastball, sinker, some variety. We're going to have to make kind of an educated guess here and just go with the four-seam, and we're correct. 16 out of 18. James Karinchak. All right, so James Karinchak. Could be slightly mispronouncing that, but regardless, this guy is textbook over the top, flat four seam, downhill, and then a breaking ball tunneled out of that four seam spot. So we know it's a four seam. We know it's a curveball. Those are the two pitches. If you know James Karinchak's repertoire, this is a curveball. We're correct. 17 out of 19. Up next, Joe Mantiply. This one's a little bit tricky. Left-handed, three quarters release point. We know he's got a sweeping curveball. We know he throws a fastball and a sinker. The thing is, this is tricky because it's 92. Sinker or four seam? This is a coin flip. That's all this is, kind of a coin flip. We aren't able to get lined up. We're not behind the pitcher, straight over the top, right? Looking right down the barrel of the pitch and any potential movement. Because of that, I have a feeling this is a sinker. And I got it wrong. Wow. Got it wrong. It was a four seam, but we go 17 out of 20. I mean, I'm pretty happy about that. Ideally, you go 20 for 20, but you can't control a lot of this stuff. We made some educated guesses. We got some right. We got some wrong. If you guys enjoyed this type of content, let me know. I enjoyed making it. I enjoyed playing along. We might do some other games here on Baseball Savant. Just kind of testing things out, seeing where we are with our baseball knowledge. And hopefully I can provide a little bit of insight and some help for you guys so that you can recognize pitches a little bit better, have some more success, not only in this game, but when you're watching baseball in this upcoming season, you can see where pitches go, where they end up, how they got there, the movement, the repertoires of these different guys. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this one. If you did, be sure to slap a like on the video, subscribe to the channel for all types of sports content. And otherwise, catch you guys in the next one. Peace.